Hey everybody, Tyler just shared his TIFF review. Make sure you check that out before we jump into video. Today's sponsors, Tyler's TIFF review. We're not getting paid for that, but you should watch it anyway, because I'm going to.
Thank you.
Because I'm awesome.
Thank you.
I like things that you might like. I'm
certainly
guess
hope so.
You like the things that I like, right, audience? Perfect.
Oh.
All right, that's my intro. But no, seriously, check out Tyler's channel. It's fantastic.
Thanks.
Today, the Josh and Tyler show, we're doing a fun thing. I compiled the top 10 trailers of 1984 in no particular order. Tyler is going to see if he can guess which one is the highest grossing to the lowest grossing. Now, 1984 is a fun year because I wanted to pick years that movies you might actually have seen or heard of. That because there was a lot of years where I'm like, well, those exist.
Yeah.
Are they good movies? Probably. But we haven't heard of them. So I have compiled a video of all the trailers, and we're going to jump into it. I'm going to do one. We're just going to play it. We'll talk during the trailers. Let me know what you think of them. Be like, is this, if you've seen, you've probably seen a bunch of these movies. The trailer could be crap.
Just
let
by looking
know.
At this picture, I can't really tell right off the bat what it's
bum,
for.
Bum, dun, 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 dun.
Hey, don't give it away. just get on with it, man.
I'm going to get on with it. Let's just do this. Here
yes,
we go, guys.
Get on with it.
Eddie Murphy is a Detroit cop.
So this came out
on vacation in Beverly Hills.
I just got off the phone with an Inspector Todd in Detroit. He says if you're out here investigating the Tandino murder, you needn't bother coming back.
I don't want to take it in.
This is actually really good.
For a man who claims to be on vacation, you look a lot like you're on a stakeout.
Stakeout? No. I'm picnicking. This is like a picnic area. I have to ask you some questions about Michael Tandino.
I never been to a cell that had a phone in it.
Can I stay for a while? Because I ordered some pizza.
We have 6 witnesses that say you broke in and started tearing up the place, then jumped out the window.
May I help you?
Yeah. I'm looking for Victor Meadman.
That part
I have nothing to say to you.
You just got your badges and your guns and you're on the job, right? Make sure we get the right drinks, because if I drink club soda, I'll throw up.
You know, this is the cleanest and nicest police car I've ever been in my life. This thing's nice in my apartment.
Little bitch, you are the pride of your department in Detroit.
Seems painfully obvious you haven't the slightest idea who you're dealing with.
I don't know what y'all think I am, giving me some kind of food. Hurry up, quicker!
I guess you're gone.
Crawl back to your little stone in Detroit before you get squashed.
Eddie Murphy, Beverly Hills Cop.
That's our first trailer here. The movie's actually really, really great.
Yeah, but like, the good thing is Beverly Hills Cop has all that reputation.
Mm-hmm. Okay.
He's the new kid in
Where
town,
Hills
and the
Cop?
Music's on his side.
Let's dance!
Footloose.
Time.
Paramount Pictures presents Footloose.
Footloose, the one from Caddyshack. This also came out in 84. Are you a fan?
I like it. Ghost. I don't love it.
Hello, Ghostbusters.
They're real.
Now, this is from the beginning of the movie, so they're not for
you.
They're here.
Yeah. We'll see what this is.
We got one!
That's a good cut.
Ghostbusters.
Hey, anybody see a ghost?
They catch the ghost that won't stay dead.
This guy's voice is in like most of the trailer.
They're armed. They're dangerous.
Try to imagine all life as you know it stopping instantaneously and every molecule in your body exploding at the speed of light.
Right, that's bad. Okay, all right, important safety tip. Thanks, Egon.
They're professionals.
Oh. Bill Murray was
I'm the chairman of the largest paranormal removal company in America.
You see it?
They're all that stand between you and the end of the world.
The city is headed for a disaster of biblical proportions.
Real wrath of God type stuff. Fire and brimstone coming down from the sky. Human sacrifice, dogs and cats living together. Mass hysteria.
Your girlfriend lives in the corner penthouse of Spook Central.
You want this body?
Is that a trick question?
Oh.
Stick.
Hold. Hit him up.
It's a
bat. Smite him. Bring him hard. Ready.
Ghostbusters.
But they show the very end of the movie.
Starring Bill Murray, Dan Aykroyd, Sigourney Weaver, Harold Ramis, Rick Moranis. Coming to save the world. Ghostbusters.
We came, we kicked it.
Its ass.
They cut it off with a...
Of course
they did. Alright, this was also released in 1984.
Steven Spielberg presents...
This is a good year, right?
Yeah, this,
Why Billy do you think Pelzer I picked this year? Because I was like,
gee, I have no idea.
Billy, is that you?
I have not seen Gremlins all the way through.
A nice job.
To know what's happening in it.
Yeah.
I enjoy it. Girl. I just haven't got around to watching
it. If you're
not
doing anything this Thursday night, maybe you'd like to go out on a date with me?
I'd love to.
I think Gremlins has transcended more to like...
Who are about to give him...
You're going to like this.
No, don't shake it. We're going to have to open it now. We'll wait till Christmas.
The most unusual gift he ever got.
What is it?
Where do you buy a thing like
your
that?
Dad.
Yeah, your dad is...
Come on, Barney, be a good dog. My dad gave it to me.
I was going
to
say weird.
But there are a few things to keep in mind. If you expose it to the light, you may hurt it. If you get it wet,
you think this trailer needed
it will
to
multiply.
All that from water? They got wet?
Yeah, plain water.
And most important, no matter how much they beg,
they never let them eat
after midnight. Because when they do,
they're really moldy croissant.
They change.
Rafe.
They become clever. Mischievous.
What's going on here?
And dangerous.
Gremlins, huh?
What's going on?
Little monster.
Like Mark Wahlberg.
Right.
Going
on?
Hundreds of them.
I don't know, maybe thousands.
Oh, fair
enough.
Yeah.
Billy, what are these things? Where do they come from?
Look, I know it sounds crazy.
It's
I know.
Actually a pretty good trailer.
But in a few hours, you're going to have a major disaster on your hands.
Gremlins, directed by Joe Dante. They'll be expecting you.
And the guy who directed Home Alone wrote this movie. That just sounds so weird.
All right,
okay.
This also came out in
Number
five came out in 84. This is a good year for movies.
Yeah.
Now you have it.
I'd rather watch Crystal Skull. There, I said it.
Has a name.
What?
It must be.
This movie has some crazy effects.
It does. That being one of
from Steven Spielberg and George Lucas.
This Shanghai car.
Indiana Jones.
I do like the falling through the awnings.
That would believe me. That's like Bruce Lee.
We have the armor of God, guys. I know, really. The mic. Yeah, I'm so short. I'm not apologizing for that.
No, I get it.
Okay, that knock was good too.
That was good.
And the fact that this, for no real reason, makes this more
reason. Yeah, no, I never got that.
Like, they're almost like they're acknowledging that it's not.
This trailer was the first movie. That was the first movie rated PG-13.
Right.
Crime. The city was full of it.
Hey! Three TVs!
Desperate measures were needed.
Want you to go to the police again?
The police are taking such a dangerous place!
Honey, don't worry!
Desperate measures were taken.
I'm joining the police force!
The mayor says we have to take this riffraff.
Moments, but so trapped other movies.
Oh, yes. We all are.
No more.
What about guns? When do we get guns?
You will be schooled in
firearms,
police procedures, local laws, and many, many other things.
High speed driving. And self-defense.
I need a volunteer.
That's me!
I love it.
Police Academy.
Where did you get this gun?
My mom gave it to me.
Mister, I am warning you.
Okay, that I
there,
see.
Leave.
Funny, Roger.
Mean.
Does the radio bother you?
Five.
I can turn it down.
I'm C. Each and every one of them striving to defend.
You make me sick.
Thank you, sir. I make everybody sick.
See the thighs.
Or upend.
Come on. I haven't got all day the thighs.
And now that they're ready for the real world. Crime is no longer the number one problem. They are.
Can you get my kitty cat out of the tree?
No problem, ma'am.
Police Academy.
Okay, you know what? I need to see Police Academy.
It's on Netflix. It's amazing. Okay. I love this thing.
Wow.
It's made for me. It's a great trailer, right? It makes you want to see the movie.
That's a great trailer.
It gives you enough of it, but it doesn't give away the jokes.
Yeah, well, it gives away some.
1984.
I'm fed up to hell with this treasure hunt business. Yeah. Ira, you miserable worm, you lied to me. You said she was a city girl. Out of her element. Just get her in the map and bring him back. Piece of cake. My butt. What went wrong?
It's clearly a Indiana Jones.
What went wrong?
It's romance.
First of all, guess who else is here?
Yeah.
Dead right, Solo.
What?
Secondly, she's got herself a partner. Like shooting holes in
everything.
Taking a stranded woman to a telephone.
It's based on a novel or something.
So,
War of
the
Roses is 75 and
Travis
Tate.
That's just the beginning of what's going on down here.
I know it's that late. She's annoying. She's like really memorable. That's the level of person you get.
Classic Tracy Pollard. Folks, his wife.
Yeah,
that looks nothing like that.
There's nothing you can say that'll make me go back into that hell.
Danny DeVito is like the other guy trying to track down the treasure.
Ira, stop it! All right, I'll go back.
He's the bad guy. In the next one, he's the good guy. The
second
one has probably the best one. The Cairo is pretty neat.
Okay.
This is also 1984.
All that they've loved, all that they've fought
my
for,
favorite Star Trek.
All that they've stood for, will now be put to the test. Star Trek III, A Search for Spock.
The word, sir? The word? Is no. I am therefore going anyway.
You do this, you'll never
I think
see
you did a really
Captain's
interesting thing with the
Engage
sci-fi, the way
systems.
They had their own reincarnated Spock. On
one quarter impulse power.
Someone is stealing the Enterprise. Warp speed.
Link up her to Bracer. She's army torpedoes.
Shields up.
The old school shields Star Trek crew.
Fuck!
Join us on this, the final voyage of the Starship Enterprise. Star Trek 3, the search for Spock. The adventure continues.
There are so many blockbusters on this. This is going to be really fucking difficult.
Hello.
Hello, Flap.
Yes.
Have you heard anything?
I cut the
No. And Emma hasn't called you either.
Let me know if you hear. And if you talk to Emma, don't sound as frightened as you do.
I don't sound frightened.
Deborah Winger. Shirley MacLaine.
You're gonna meet Emma in the trailer.
Jack Nicholson.
Please call Emma. This is Garrett.
Pleasure to meet you. I've heard so much about you.
Yes, well, your mother's really been looking forward to this, too. So, go ahead.
Anything wrong, Garrett?
No.
I'll be over later. They're probably tired anyway, and will get to sleep early, and I'd like to get to bed early. Bye-bye.
Terms of endearment.
There's that one guy's
like, not gonna lie, like, the first couple minutes were better.
Well, I needed a quick clip.
No, that's fair. That's totally
this was also 1984.
This is the end of the line.
Telling me.
Did I tell you about the pool here?
For Daniel LaRusso,
is this the only movie you guys got?
The future seemed far from terrific.
You like this movie?
This is a dump. I should go back to New Jersey. Hey, I know it's hard, but...
This is like my childhood.
We're not quitters, are we?
Until
he
met the right girl.
Hi. She's beautiful. I see.
Yeah, Elizabeth's shoe was like my first crush.
Is that your address?
Really?
Yeah, I was like 6 years old.
But only anger the wrong guy.
You know, I was a country
club 9:30.
Definitely.
You gotta be nuts.
And his troubles really begin.
I think this trailer spoils a few too many scenes from the movie.
This trailer also makes Ralph Macchio
look man.
Yeah, he's not.
Because as everyone has pointed out over and over
and over,
he is kind of
nuts.
I like
you do that. No. First time. Power. Whole body. Make a perfect picture.
But how do I know if my picture's the right one?
If come from inside you, always right on. Lesson about the balance, not just karate,
like
lesson
for
all life.
No, maybe it
might drink.
So I won't have to fight.
Wasn't what happened.
Hey, karate kid, let's take a move.
No points or no points, you're dead meat.
I don't have much of a cheering section.
You got me.
In the end, it will be in Daniel's hands.
In his mind.
And most of all, in his mind.
No mercy.
Yeah.
Columbia Pictures presents.
It's basically Rocky.
The Karate Kid.
What kind of belt you have?
Yeah, they did.
You like? JCPenney, 398.
I made that funny.
All right, so I'm going to pause that. So, what do you think? I'm going to give you a moment or two. While you're ordering
them. Oh, shit, that's 10.
That's 10. What was your favorite trailer of all those?
Police Academy, without question. It's
genuinely really funny.
Oh, my God. Wow. Yeah.
You want to watch it now, don't you?
Maybe a little bit.
So what do you think? So I'll give you a moment to do your top 10.
Fuck.
So just start going, I guess, I don't know, however you want to do it.
I was going to guess what numbers... I was going to start, like, from what was number one and work my way down, if that works
for you. Do it up, yeah.
I am going to say number one. I'm going to guess Ghostbusters.
Let's see here. You'd be correct.
Okay. Because that just seems That just seems the more likely scenario.
Ghostbusters released on June 8th, 1984, and made $220 million.
Yeah, because originally Animal House was the most successful comedy of all time, and then Ghostbusters overtook that. That's kind of, I don't really know that much about box office numbers, but that's one that I heard in a Canadian documentary about comedies, because I mean, Animal House was made by Ivan Reitman,
yep.
And with all the Canadian talent in Ghostbusters, that's how they played into that.
Mm-hmm.
Speaking of comedies, for number two, I'm going to go with Beverly Hills Cop.
You would be incorrect.
Okay. For number two, then, I'll
give you two guesses for each number.
Okay. For number two, I'll guess Temple of Doom.
You would be correct. It released on May 23rd. In 1984, made $179 million.
Okay. Number three, my first guess is going to be Beverly Hills Cop.
That is also incorrect.
Footloose?
That's not correct. It was actually Gremlins.
Gremlins?
It was released on June 8th, same day as Ghostbusters, and made $148 million.
Okay, so I did...
Good for Gremlins, right?
For debuting alongside one of these other movies, that's actually pretty good.
It opened up against Ghostbusters. That's not something you can do easily.
No. Number four. Footloose?
Number four is not Footloose.
Beverly Hills Cop?
It is not. It is The Karate Kid. It made $90 million and opened on June 22nd. June was a stacked month.
Yeah, no kidding.
Yeah. Number five, what is your guess?
Footloose?
It is not Footloose.
Beverly Hills Cop.
It is not. It is Police Academy. It opened on May 23rd and made $81 million.
This just seems so weird.
This is I went off Box Office Mojo, whatever. IMDb something.com.
Okay, number six, I'm going to go with The Search for Spock.
That is not number six.
I'm going to be repeating myself to death on this one. Beverly Hills Cop.
It is Beverly Hills. No, number six? No, it's not. Just kidding. It's Footloose. It made $80 million and opened February 17th. This was a February movie.
Okay. Well, there's no way in hell Beverly Hills Cop outdid... there's no way Romance in the Stone outdid Beverly Hills Cop, so I'm going to do number seven.
Number seven is Beverly Hills Cop. It opened December 5th. It was a January movie, and it made $77 million.
See, with the reputation that it has, that just... feels so misleading.
Number eight, what are your guesses here?
I'm going to say Terms of Endearment.
Terms of Endearment is nine, Search for Spock is eight, and number 10 is Romancing the Stone.
That sounds perfectly accurate.
So what is your biggest surprise on this list of which one didn't... Was it Beverly Hills Cop not being number one?
Yeah, I was amazed that it wasn't even in the top five, given how many people consider it one of the great comedies of the 80s.
Hmm. Fair enough. But yeah, that's 1984's top 10 movies. What a year to be alive, right?
Yeah, no kidding.
Anyway, that's it for the Josh and Tyler Show. Check out this guy. He's got videos on the Tyler Wolf channel. My arms wiggle weirdly. Tyler, what's up? Say something awesome in one of the videos.